Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Let's go get our revenge on the bone ball. And get our souls back. I'm pretty sure this is safe. It's not gonna follow me, is it? Okay, I think I'm okay. Wait. This isn't even where I wanted to go. I mean, I was half right. I did want to go down here, but I didn't want to come up the ladder. Oh god. You're still here. Reminds me, this ring seems to do literally nothing. Not sure what the definition of successive attacks is, but apparently it's very different from mine, so let's put something actually useful on. Lowering equipment load increases attack. You know what? Now that I'm wearing lighter armor, that could potentially actually do something. Let's see. Because if I take off my halberd, which I don't really need to have on me, I'm down to 37%. I think 30% is the threshold for being able to do the long rolls. So I'm actually not too far from even being able to do that. The torch even has weight, but not much. Okay, so my damage right now is 128 plus 41. 128 plus 41, 128 plus 41, 128 plus 41, 128 plus 41? It did nothing? Or do I have to check it here? 174. Oh, 169. Yeah, so it gives me 5 more damage, which is really not that much, but it is something. Okay, so I could do that. Increase bleed resistance, fire damage absorption. Okay, so yeah, it's either increase my damage by 5, or increase my bleed resistance or fire damage absorption. I guess Flynn's Ring. Man! Oh, shit! You mother... Arrow shooting little bastard back there messing me up. Oh, there goes my souls. Thank you. Okay, this is just pathetic. Come on. That got him angry. Okay, hitting me through the wall, that's not fair. Jesus Christ. Oh, no, don't see me, don't see me. Not just yet. Okay. Okay, so I'm actually getting bleeding from these enemies when they hit me. They're actually increasing my bleeding, so you know what? I'm actually gonna put on my bleed resistance for now. Why do I even try that attack? I'll try it again! Why do I even try that attack? I burned through so many of my Estuses. Just sad. Alright, so where does this bone ball come from? It dropped down and rolled down here. From whence do you come? Is it up there? Is it back here? I don't see it. Can I go down enough to then run back up here and dodge it, or do I have to just keep running down? Or maybe I need to get on one of these things. Yeah, you know, if I went onto one of these things, I'd probably be okay. Let's see if I can get this enemy to come up at me. Or not. Forget it. Jesus Christ. That thing is so creepy! Is it an enemy? Where does it go? Oh, it just rolls back and forth. Ooh. Yeah, I can't target it, so I don't think it's like a normal enemy. It's an environmental hazard.
Why did I try that? I wanted to see if I could stab it. I didn't know it would repel me like a magnet.
I wonder if I can drop down. No, I would not survive that. I wonder if Dark Souls 3 has that cat ring. Whatever it's called, like in Dark Souls 2, that allows you to survive further falls. That'd be pretty sweet. If I don't move, it can't see me. If I don't move, it can't see me. If I don't move, it can't see me. If I don't move, it can see me! Whoa, 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 whoa! Slow it down. Slow it down. That invisible attack is very confusing. Okay, come on. It does not care about me. Okay. Do not stab the bone ball. Oh god. Right. Fucking archers. First they were the archers, and then I moved, and then I purposely dodged forwards because I think that enemy that was about to hit me was gonna knock me off, and then I dodged into the ball and died. Okay. I think I gotta run down all at one time. If I stay in one place for too long, I'm just gonna get poked full of holes by the archers. I'm getting so many shards from these things. Whoa! You know, I have to wonder, if I run down there and just ignore these enemies, would they get killed by the bone ball? I'm gonna try it. Catch me if you can! Quickly! Yes! Oh. Oh, there's an item up there. That one just died. Okay, I'm gonna go for the item in just a second. Come on, come on. Here we go. Okay. Oh, I think I'm safe. Oh, hey there, buddy. Nice. What is it doing? Bye. Scaredy Skelly. It's a handle. I mean, a device to open this thing up, and the handle's broken off. whoa.
Danger.
Ow.
No. I'm in serious danger here, holy shit. No, the ball's gonna come back. Get out of there. Jesus Christ, where are these things coming from? Oh, I thought I was dead. Fuck. It's coming from you, isn't it? Okay, we're stabilizing. Just come back to life. If you did, please stay dead. What's that? Bone shard. Did the ball explode or something? I don't know what just happened. Man, there's gotta be a bonfire somewhere. It's been so long. So long. Oh. It's a grenade. Okay, come on now. Oh man, they do so much damage. That's a lot of urns. Something over there. I think it's an item. Only one way to find out. I knew it. I knew there was something in some of these. Oh, it's the ones with the cloth covering them, right? Like this one? Yep. Okay. Karthus Milk Ring. Slightly boosts dexterity and obscures rolling. Ring worn by warriors of the Sand Kingdom, Karthus. The sword technique of Karthus allows for fluid movement with a curved sword. Masters of the technique are said to dazzle their opponents by moving as weightlessly as a grain of sand. They live for their High Lord Walnir, conqueror of most kingdoms known to their people. Ah, it does that when you dodge. I think I wondered this when I got a similar ring in Dark Souls 2. And what I wondered was, this obscures rolling, does that have any effect whatsoever on NPCs? It definitely would on players. Players would probably find it much harder to see where you're going and where you are, but to NPCs, does it make any difference? Boosts dexterity, so what's my current dexterity? What? It says slightly boosts dexterity. It boosts my dexterity by 3. It goes from 17 to 20. That is not a slight increase. That means I can now craft and use that weapon that I was talking about. That I could use the transposing kiln, using the soul of the cursed rotted greatwood to make. I'm just gonna leave that ring on constantly. It's worth it for the dexterity alone. Trap ahead. Oh, I see it. Right there. Good one.
What does it do, though? The arrows again. I know exactly what to do with you. Come here. Oh no, it missed. There we go. Oh god, bad idea. Look at my obscured rolling! Fancy, isn't it? Aw, yeah. Putting that obscured rolling to good use? I seriously need a bonfire. Well, given my increased dexterity, let's use this opportunity to go craft that weapon. Oh, and I also want to use that key, the key to the tower that I bought for 20,000 souls. I looked it up on a wiki, and it looks like I am definitely missing an area. So I'll talk about that in a little bit after I've bought this, after I've transposed the weapon. I believe it was 1,000 souls to transpose it. And now I'm not on the right one. Oh my god. Yeah, 1,000.
Now. Do not be away.
All right, let's check this thing out. So, comparing stats, it does... significantly less damage. The base damage is pretty good, because it's not upgraded at all, and it already does close to my base damage of my S-Talk, even without being +3. But the scaling damage is not very good. And that's because it scales poorly with strength, and it also doesn't quite scale as well on dexterity. I wonder if I can use the sharp gem on a transposed weapon, just like I did on my S-Stock, to make it scale better with dexterity. I'll check that out in a second. Significantly heavier, but that's fine. Alright, let's try it. Wow, that is a bizarre weapon. It really is like a mini spear. It looks pretty long, actually. Let's compare the length. I think it's actually longer. Okay. Light attack. It's pretty fast. Let me put my S-Talk on, actually, just to compare the attack speeds. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I think it feels maybe slightly slower, but it's still pretty fast. Here's a strong attack. Okay, so it's a big forwards attack. With a good range, too. Okay, now let's do the special attack. An even stronger forwards attack. Okay, I'm gonna try this thing out. Let's go see if I can upgrade it. Oh, right, and I have the Pyromancer's Tome.
Well, well. I've never seen anything like this. This inscription. This tome is from the catacombs. Fascinating. On this day, the teacher learns alongside the pupil. Do not be gone for long.
Also, while I'm here, I might as well go see if I can draw out my inner strength once again.
Oh, I... Then shall we begin?
I still find it creepy that I can keep doing this. It doesn't seem right. Alright, well, I have plenty of dexterity considering the ring. What do I need? What do I need the most? What do I need the most? Health is always good. Stamina is always good. Let's go with health.
Be safe. That is, wasn't it?
Alright, so can I infuse it? No? Yeah, so you can't infuse special weapons, so I can't make it sharp, so whatever it scales right now is what it's always going to scale. That's disappointing. Yeah, that's really disappointing. It doesn't scale that well with dexterity, just a C. Okay, can I reinforce it? Titanite scale. Ooh, that increases the damage by quite a bit.
Pretty, be careful.
Alright, I want to give this weapon a serious try. So I'm going to upgrade it as much as I can. Oh yeah, and the Estus Shard thing. Need to use it at the other place. The bonfire. The shrine bonfire. Oh, I need a bunch more Titanite scales to get it up again. Okay, well already it does a lot of damage.
Be careful.
I'm gonna compare the damage in just a second. Against my S-Doc. Estus plus 3. Okay, so comparing damage against my S-Doc. Let's see. Ooh. Yeah, wow. Upgrading it made a huge difference. It actually does quite a bit more damage now. And it does poison. And it's only plus 2, it's not even plus 3. Okay, let's give this weapon a real try. I'm excited. This weapon might be amazing, actually. Should I go try to use the key or just go back? I'm gonna go back. Because if I go to where I use the key, I'm pretty sure there's not gonna be a lot of combat there. That's what I feel like anyway. So I'm gonna go to where the action is. But I'm also probably gonna suck against these enemies with this new weapon because I'm not used to it. Got like 17 hours of experience with the S-Doc, and zero experience with this. Can I poison bones? Oh my God, that did so much damage. I was doing... welcome back. I was doing like 60-something damage with my S-Dog. This is doing like twice the damage. It's not from the base damage, it's just... I don't know, I guess the type of weapon it is for some reason does more. What does it say? It doesn't say anything about it being specifically good against a type of enemy. What kind of a weapon is it? So it's a spear thrust, and an S-Stock is a thrusting sword, standard slash thrust. Okay, so they're classified as different types of weapons with different types of attacks. This one is just thrust, this one is standard slash thrust. So maybe that's what's making it do more damage? I don't know. Oh, fuck. Fuck! Jesus Christ! Oh my god, I almost killed myself two times there, and then got so distracted by the fact that I died. Alright, it's fine. It's fine, it's fine, it's fine. Not worried about my souls, just trying to feel out this weapon. Hmm, 160-something, 145. Okay, even a fully charged-up strong attack does not do that much more damage. So the strong attack is actually not about damage, it's about... Did I just do a bash? What was that? I don't even know how I did that. But yeah, the strong attack's not about doing more damage, really. It's more about breaking the poise of the enemy, it seems like. Come on. Now that I'm trying to do the lunge, there we go, the lunge on purpose, it wasn't working. Okay. So if I do the light attack plus forwards, that's what does the kick thing that I did accidentally. That's the same thing that did the backwards attack on the S-Dock, where I like whacked at the enemy's feet and then like did this. Like I went back. It was like an attack at the feet plus back dodge. But this kick is the equivalent for this weapon. It's just so hard to do consistently. Obviously joined me in hell. It's not doing too well against shields. I'm thinking my thrusting sword is probably better against shields. So much damage against these enemies, though. I love it. The enemy just tried to attack me and fell off. Oh no, it didn't quite fall off. Oh, now it did. Oh, I was trying to do the kick. Alright, let's see how against it does this enemy. Not doing too much damage against this enemy. Ooh. I think I might really like this weapon. Yeah, if you roll and then attack, it does a nice, like, upward kind of slash. Which seems to be doing a very good job at hitting the enemy. Because with the S-Talk, it was much more directed. If you dodged, like if you rolled and then attacked, it just did a normal poke, which means you had to aim it very specifically in the direction of the enemy. Which I kind of liked, honestly. It was kind of fun to dodge to the side and then poke their backs, but this one might be a bit more consistent. Wow. I think I'm actually going to stick with this weapon. I think I like it quite a bit. I'm not sure if I'm going to find the poison to be of any use, though. So yeah, that attack is specifically meant to break their shield block. It's just so inconsistent! Like, whoa. Arrow? Oh right, you. Consistent. Seriously, I've practiced trying to get these things down. I've practiced trying to get the special abilities or whatever you want to call them. The lunging attack and the light attack thing. It's where you gotta flick the movement stick forwards and light or heavy attack at the same time. I've tried to get it consistent. I practiced it for like a half hour in Dark Souls 2. Never could get it consistent. And it's exactly the same in this game, just as inconsistent. I don't get it. Honestly, I feel like it's the 60 FPS problem. Like, in Dark Souls 2, there was a severe issue where... because on PC you got 60 FPS, there was a bug where it increased the rate at which weapons degraded in their durability. More frames equaled more damage. As if it was calculating the damage per frame. I feel like the window in which you're able to do these special abilities is perhaps within a couple frames instead of a certain amount of time. In other words, I feel like, let's say there's 2 frames in which you can do it. Let's say the window is 2 frames. If you're running at 30 FPS and you have a two frame window, then you have 2/30ths of a second in which to hit the buttons correctly. If you have a 2-frame window, in 60 FPS you have 2/60ths of a second in which to hit the window. I've got a feeling that's what's going on. I've got knives sticking out of my body. Ow. Goodbye. Next. The enemy in a stun lock, this weapon is absurdly powerful. Okay. Is the ball defeated for good, or is it gonna come back? It's coming back. There's like an archer that falls down or something. Waiting for that to happen. Come on. Maybe not. I'm gonna get ya. Just hold on a second, buddy. It goes away when you defeat that enemy? Was it summoned by this thing or something? Strange. Oh hey, there's a bonfire on the other side of that. I just realized. Not that that really helps. Can't I just stick my weapon inside of there and use it as a new handle? When are they gonna wake up? Here we go. Made it a lot further with a lot. Made it a lot further with a lot more Estoc, or Estus, than before. Right. So off to the right, there's a bonfire somewhere over there. Oh, right. Whoops. But I can't get there through here. Let's not try to exploit the trap to kill the enemy. That just ended up killing me. That skeleton's gonna wake up. Oh, I think I see a break in the wall, so I think the bonfire is just right through there. Yo, don't die again. Come on.
Are you kidding me? Dude, we had like 1 point left.
Okay, I'm gonna bring that enemy back next time so I don't get hit by the spirit bombs. I'm so close. So close to the Bonnie. Gonna try the good old run strat. Oh, fuck. Oh, that was close. Don't be too impressed by my jumping attack. That was actually completely by accident. Good, I don't have a bleeding resistance ring on anymore. I don't think I need it. Hit it! Ah, I made it out. No, you... Should crack now. Yep, we're good. That little mischievous bastard. It looks like when the skeletons decide to resurrect, that's not like a random effect. It seems to be a specific status of a specific enemy as one that will resurrect. Because the same enemy is resurrected this time as it did last time. Okay. Alright. Yes, pull one at a time. Are you coming? Oh, it's possible to make them appear, but they don't actually see you. It has no intention of actually coming after me, does it? Alright, I think we're good now. I'm gonna backstab you. Ew. Rats. I don't think you can make that jump. I think you gotta get there from some other way. Oh, God. No, don't see me. Don't see me. Oh, wait. I thought that was a crack in the wall. It's not really a crack in the wall. That's actually where I have to go, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Okay. So I'm not quite to the bonfire. Alright. It's okay. I've got 5 flasks. I'm good. Let's get one enemy at a time. Come on. Hey, they can go through pillars, no fair. Why can't I be incorporeal too? That was so pathetic. I kinda wanna do some PvP now. I feel like between this weapon and the fact that I disappear when I dodge, that I'm gonna be very, very confusing for my opponent. Oh, it's a trap. What does it do? Same thing, come on, give me a new trap. You. Look what I'm stepping on. Mountains of bones. Okay, I think the bonfire is just through here. Is that another one? Yep. Alright, where's the dude? I know there's a dude somewhere. Just hanging out. creepy. Ooh, there's a bonfire. But first, what does this say? Boulder. Indeed. Praise the boulder. Bonfire, bonfire. Bonfire, yes! Oh, finally. I've officially made progress in this place. I'm gonna poke it. Wow, I've actually got 10,000 souls. Should be enough to level up. One thing that I've realized about this weapon, though, I was talking about how when you dodge and then attack, it does this, like, uppercut. It does have a wider, wider angle of attack in which you can actually hit your enemy with this. However, I've realized when I was fighting that really fast, glowing red-eyed enemy, the one with the scythe, I realized that it doesn't have the range that the S-Doc does with its poke. This is a very close attack. You have to be very close to the enemy, otherwise it won't hit them. Not necessarily worse, just different. Wider angle of attack, but you have to be closer.
Well, then talking.
Okay, what now? Why does that say that the attack power of my weapon is garbage?
Farewell, Ashen One. Well, speak, then touch him.
Yeah, I don't understand. Why? I'm looking at the damage, attack power, and it looks like it's garbage? I don't understand. That doesn't seem to be reflecting the fact that I'm holding the weapon. So I don't know what's up with that. Anyway. Vitality, endurance. Let's go with endurance. Stamina is always good.
Farewell, Ashen Maiden.
So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm going to go back to the catacombs of Karthus.